Hello again.
So I think what we're going to do is we are going to Okay, so we are going to make some onion rings in the air fryer. I'm so excited. Oops, I don't want to set my eggs on the wood, mother. So here are the onion rings that I've been savoring to make homemade onion rings. So we got the onion rings. These are ready. Just gonna crack a couple of eggs and grab some flour. Okay, had to finish my soda, sorry. I really gotta find a better place for that cookbook of mine. Not a lot of room with the air fryer. Getting pushed down the counter. So we're gonna just take a cup of flour. About a cup, I suppose. I don't know, you don't need to measure this flour. I think that's about enough. So these breadcrumbs that I have here are homemade. I made them this morning, seasoned them, and that looked good. So homemade breadcrumbs to make onion rings with. Crack a couple of eggs. Uh-oh. Got a piece in there. Doesn't want to come out. Come on. Now it's in a little ridge. I got it.
Sucker.
I think one more egg. If I can do it without getting it. I broke the yolk though. That's not good. We need a little tray with some parchment paper on there. We're going to preheat this thing that we're going to set them here until it's ready for them to go in. This usually gets preheated before I can finish what I'm doing, so. And I'm gonna do the fry setting for French fries. Hopefully that's gonna be the right setting. It usually just goes high in 20 minutes, so. Utensils for all this. Then we're going to dip it back in the egg. Then we're going to dip it in the breadcrumbs. Get it all good and covered. There we are. It's not sticking as well as I thought it would. I wonder why. Egg there. My hand is gonna get really, really bad. Back in the egg and over to the breadcrumbs. It's not really holding together there. We'll see. I think it's going to be good. I think they're going to be delicious. That one's a good one. That one ended really nicely. Oh, egg first, then flour, then egg, then breadcrumbs. Still preheating. Got three ready. Get a big one. Heating for a long time. This is a long one. There we go. That's a big one. I get a few more done. Uh-oh. Okay, I gotta add, I'm gonna add these five in there. I'll just add as I go. I didn't do egg again. Darn it. Egg. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and put those in. How many? It says for 15 minutes. Even if you're getting them in late from the machine, you can still reset that time. Alright, so we're gonna lay this in here. I guess, I don't know. We're gonna put them in there. These turn out good. Hope, hope, hope. Okay, I think I can fit one more. Let's get that one more in there. Flour. Egg. Breadcrumbs. No more egg. Egg in there. Going right on, right in. You know what? I think I can do one more. Absolutely. I'm gonna do it. Hope I didn't have the drawer out too long. That's okay. If it did, we'll just do it our way. I did it my way. Do everything my way. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just doing it. You know what I mean? I'm testing the waters here. Okay. Perfect. And now we can just start it at 15. I don't think it's going to need 15 minutes, but we will see. And in that 15 minutes, I will make a second batch. Okay, we are still working on these onion rings, and these are looking good. I haven't checked these. It's 10 minutes. We're going to check. Maybe we'll turn them over, right? So I'm thinking, maybe we should turn them over. Oh yeah, definitely. We need to turn them over. And then I got to decide. Ooh, what kind of sauce I'm gonna. What kind of sauce? Ooh, a dill sauce would be amazing. Yes, okay, so I'm gonna make it like a dill mayonnaise. Those are good. We're gonna go about, I wanna say, 5 more minutes on that. I only got a couple of onions left. So we'll go ahead and do those real quick. Okay, I'm going to call these. They look delicious, but I am calling them. Okay, so we are going to put them right onto a plate. That's what we're going to do. Oh, they're going to be delicious. Have to excuse me. Oh, and the second batch is going to go in. I think they're a little overdone, but I think they're going to still be delicious. So we did 5, 7 minutes. So we're going to go 7 minutes and turn them halfway. That's what we're going to do. Buzzer's going off. Sorry about that. Okay, getting the last batch in. Oh, they're all going to fit, I think. I think they're all going to fit. Okay, they all fit. Yay. Here they are inside the fryer, and we're going to put them inside. And they're gonna be delicious. We're gonna go 3 minutes. Wait. We're gonna check them at three. Or check them. Yeah, in 3 minutes. We're gonna check them. And there's 4 minutes left. With these and set those aside. Okay, so I'm going to get some dill out here. Okay, so we're going to make a little dipping sauce for the onion rings real quick. Mayonnaise, we're going to start with a little mayonnaise. A little bit of salt. A little bit of pepper. Juice it up with a little bit of ranch. Maybe a little more ranch. A tad bit of lemon juice in there. That's dill. Yeah, about that much. Let's do that together. Oh my gosh, it looks delicious. Oh my gosh. Let's see. Let's do a taste test after we get them all. Get all the seasonings good mixed together. I didn't make enough, but it'll have to do. One more dill. Looks delicious. Mm. That's definitely inviting on the tongue for sure. Mm. That's delicious. All right, so this is going to go in my cookbook. So don't be taking my recipe. No, I'm teasing. So we got some mayonnaise. Oh no, it says it's burnt. Burnt? What the fuck are you talking about? They're not burnt. No, these are not burnt. They look pretty perfect to me. I mean, this is my first time ever making onion rings. So I think I'm doing pretty good. I got a hair. I got a hair at my, no, in my mouth. Okay, so I'm gonna put them in for another, because I just turned them, right? We're gonna go for 1 minute on that side. Let's see. Okay, now we're gonna test it. That definitely going in my book. Mayonnaise, ranch, lemon, and dill, and salt and pepper. Mm. Oh my God. I'm in heaven, you guys. I really am. Okay, we're going to call it right there. These ones over here did get a little dark, but they are delicious. So these are lighter. Mm. Oh man. Homemade breadcrumbs, homemade dipping sauce. Can't ask for better. Look at that plate. Homemade onion rings. With dill dipping sauce. We're gonna let that cool just like that. Unplug it. And we are going to enjoy. Everything's off. Making sure everything's off. And we're going to enjoy this. I'm gonna be a double dipper. Guess who else is eating off this? Nobody. Mmm. Oh my God, look at that. As for the breadcrumbs, this is what I did. And I gotta tell you, man, best taste of bread onion rings I've ever had. So I cooked some toast, right? And I got a little real toasty, crumbled it up, put it in a baggie, ran my roller over it. I added Parmesan cheese, the dry Parmesan. I added some salt and pepper. And I added some parsley. And this is amazing. I didn't film that one. The onion rings are amazing. Mmm. Mmm. I'm in heaven. But my dog can't have onions. So no onion ring for you. Sorry, Skippy. I'll get one of his bacon strips and put a little bit of the sauce on it. I love it. Mmm. Yum, yummy. That is a yum, yummy. Mm-hmm. 100% success on this, on that. Mm. Amazing. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming to my channel and watching my video. I appreciate it. If you haven't yet subscribed, please do so and hit the bell notification to all. And give me a like and a comment. All right. And share it out if you want to. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day. Bye, y'all.